Good morning, my dear students. Myself Navneet Kaur, and I'm going to teach you English language in your 6th and 7th class. Both I'm going to teach the topic. The topic is direct and indirect speech. So, all of you listen properly so that afterwards you will solve the exercises yourself. So, let us start with direct and indirect speech on your page number 111 in 6th class. So, the actual words used by the speaker are called direct words, means in two ways we are going to narrate or report our talkings or any message which we want to convey to someone. So, two ways. First one is direct, means whatever is said by somebody, we will change the wording and tell the same message to anybody else in our own wordings. And second one is indirect way, that we are not going to use the exact actual wordings. So, actual words used by a speaker are called direct speech. So, here is an example for you. He said, I have passed the examination. She said, I have passed the examination. Means, reporting verb is the word said, and you have to use comma after the said. And first word of quoted speech begins with the capital letter. Quoted speech means whatever is there in double inverted commas, that is quoted speech. And in other part, quoted speech, there are also two parts. One is inverted commas, which close the whole statement, and reported speech, you have to after comma you have to write and close it with both double inverted commas. So, this is the way to write the sentence in a direct speech. Next one is indirect speech. In indirect speech, we give an account of someone has said, but without quoting the actual words that are used. We just use our own words to convey the same message to someone else. Here is an example again for you. She said, like in previous example, she said, comma, inverted commas, I have passed the examination, comma, close. So, this is the way of direct speech. In indirect speech, how can you change? You can change in the way she said, same you have to write, she said, but instead of comma, you put that here, T-H-A-T, that conjunction you have to use. After connection, your same subject, that is in the reported speech, you have to use the same subject. She had passed the examination, means previously use comma and inverted commas for your direct speech, and indirect speech, remove commas, remove inverted commas and put that, and use the same subject which was there in the speech. So, she here is a subject of reporting verb. Said here is your reporting verb. That here is a conjunction that is used after removing inverted commas. And she here is a first person pronoun. I is changed into she. In first sentence, I have passed is written. So, I is changed into first person pronoun she. And next one, I had passed the examination, is the verb forms of the present tense are changed into verb form of the past tense. So, this is how can you change the direct into indirect. And after that, there are so many rules which you have to follow when you change the direct speech into indirect speech. Means, some are related to pronouns, some are related to tenses. So, let us start with the rules. If the reported verb is in the present or a future tense, the tense of your reported speech is not changed. You are not going to change the tense of reported speech. Mind it. Don't get confused between reported speech and reported verb. So, reported, if your reported verb is in present, then the tense of reported speech is not changed. For example, the principal says, Mohan is an intelligent student. So, how can you change? The principal says that Mohan is an intelligent student. So, here you can remove the comma and inverted commas and put that. And next one is If the reported verb is in past tense, the tense of reported speech is also changed into past participle. But here there are other tenses also, means if your direct speech is in present simple, you can, when you change it into indirect, then you change the tense also. In case of present simple, you can change it into past simple. But if your direct speech is in present continuous, then you can change it into past continuous. And if your direct is in present perfect, then you can change into past perfect. Same like this, past simple change into past perfect and past continuous change into past perfect continuous. Here are next year rules related to pronouns, personal pronouns. First person pronouns are changed according to the subject of verb. For example, he said, I am well. And after that, how can you change it into indirect? She said that he was unwell. Means you can put that here, and the person you can change I into he, means first person pronoun changing into according to the subject. What was the subject here? He. So you can use he, same subject you have to change, use he. If he is there, then in reported speech you have to use he. Next one is second person pronouns are changed into the object of the reporting speech. Means second, if there are a second person pronouns, which are the second person pronouns? You, yours. So when these are there in your direct speech, you can change it into according to the object of the reported speech. He said to me, you have So he said to me, you have spoken falsely. How can you change it? He told me that I had spoken falsely. In indirect, you can use I on the place of second person pronoun you. And next, in case of third person, words expressing nearness in time or place generally change into words expressing distance. Means when we are going to use some proper words like ago, you can use it with the other word also. Like ago, you can change it into before. Thus, so, now, then, today, that day, this, this, these into that, those, tomorrow into the next day. Like if you yesterday, the previous day, last night, these words are used instead of particular words which you mostly use in the direct speech. But indirect, you can use it like that, like yesterday into the previous day. The is must you have to use, and last night into previous night. So these are the words which you can use in your indirect direct and indirect speech, but change accordingly, like related to time and place if they are. Next one is conversion of imperative sentences. So previously what we read, like firstly we read that how, what is the formation, how can you change, like omitting commas, omitting inverted commas. Secondly, like in personal pronouns, tenses two are there. And next one is how you, this time you can learn how we convert imperatives, means tenses and personal pronouns you have read. So third type is conversion of imperative sentences. In reporting speech, in reporting a command, a request or an advice in the indirect speech, what are the imperatives? Which include command, order, request, advice. So, reporting verb is changed into order, request or advice. Some other suitable words can also be used, like ask, beg, command, forbid, invite, tell, urge, etc. The verb of reported speech is changed into an infinitive also, like to go, to open. For example, mother said to me, put the flower vase on the table. In indirect, you can write like that, mother told me. So, mother told me to put the flowers on the table. Next one are conversion of interrogative sentences. How can you convert interrogative sentences from direct to indirect? In reporting, an interrogative sentence means when you ask a question from someone. The reporting verb is changed into asked, inquired, demand. These words you have to use in indirect speech. Instead of asking question or proper questionary words, you can use inquired, ask and demand. Next, whether or if is used after reporting verb when the question begins with have, has, do, did, is, are, etc. If your questions start with have, has, do, did or is, am, are, then you can use if or whether for the beginning of your questions. And when the answer to these questions is in either yes or no. Questions begin with interrogative words like how, why, where, who, which, when, etc. Do not take the word if, whether. If, whether is only used with has, have, do, did, is, am, are. So don't use the question words with don't use this if and whether with other questionary words which are start with WHO or how. The interrogative form is changed into the assertive form. Question mark is dropped. When you are going to change interrogative into a simple assertive sentence, then you can drop the question mark also at the end. For example, he said to me, why did you insult me? He asked me why I insulted him. So here you are not going to change it into if, whether, because there is a why. So as it is, you have to write. Next one, conversion of exclamatory sentences. In reporting, a wish or an exclamation means when you are going to wish something, like may I got that Mercedes car, like it is the wish of yours. So the reporting verb is changed into wish, bless, cry, exclaim, pray, etc. with phrases like with regret, with delight, with sorrow. Means it depends upon the word which you are going to use. If there is a alas word there, then it means you are expressing sorrow. If there is a hurrah word over there in your sentence, then it means you are showing your excitement, happiness, surprising. So exclamations such as oh, well, alas, etc. are dropped. Exclamatory sentences is changed to assertive sentences, and that is usually added as connector also in order to connect the sentence. And exclamation mark is also omitted like the question mark is in interrogatives. For example, I said how happy he is. How can you change it? I exclaimed. So instead of using said or any other reported verb, you can change it into exclaimed word. I exclaimed with joy means how happy he is, showing the happiness now. So he is going to write I exclaimed with joy. If there is any sad word there, alas, then you can write like I exclaimed with sorrow. So here you can write I exclaimed with joy that he was very happy. So this is all in your direct and indirect chapter. So both of you students of class 6th and 7th, do your exercises and only doing after reading the rule regulations. Like first I am going to tell to the 6th class students that in A part you are going to change words into an indirect speech by reading the rules. Next, B part, change the following paragraph. Full paragraph is there and you have to change it into a reported speech. And C part is there to complete the sentences in reported speech. You can write from your own. Like Amit said to me, please lend me your pen. You can write like that. Amit requested me to lend him my pen. And same with the 7th class students. There is only one exercise after your exercises. This is also same like this, that you have to change the sentences into indirect speech. So do it well. All the best and thank you.